Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Amma ba'du. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, before we commence with today's lecture, let us praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything that He has bestowed upon us. And inshallah, in return, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevate our iman and increase our taqwa in Him, inshallah. We then humbly ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send prayers, blessings and salutations to our beloved Prophet Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Peace and blessings be upon him. We then humbly ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide ease and facilitations for those who are facing hardships and tribulations in life. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide cure for those who are feeling unwell currently during this testing period. And finally, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all of our sins, to forgive our beloved ones, our colleagues, our families, and Muslimin and Muslimat all around the world. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining me in today's final lecture of this Road to Ramadan series with me, Ustaz Khidir. And inshallah, I'll be going through in depth about the main topic for today, which is about wealth. But before that, let me just share a bit about what is wealth in Islam. So basically, wealth, we can consider it as a concept of charity. So the concept of charity is why in Islam. So every good deed can be considered as charity. So now, what do we call charity in Islam? What is charity or sadaqah in Islam? So now, charitable giving is one of the most fundamental obligations prescribed in Islam. It is highly encouraged and emphasized in the Quran and Hadith as the noblest way of spending the wealth for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and helping the needy, which should be the common practice of every Muslim. In general, charity is defined as an organization that raises money to help people in need and also an act of kindness and understanding towards others. It is also described as the benevolent act towards the love of humanity pertaining to generosity and helpfulness towards people in need by giving aid in terms of food, money or others. In Islam, charity comes from an Arabic word sadaqah, which has several meanings. Firstly, sadaqah means to be truthful, which is the antonym to lies, and is associated with someone who has noble characters and manners. It is also defined as whatever given to the needy for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and can also mean a dowry given by your husband to his wife. In general, sadaqah means a noble act of giving by a person to others sanctified for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in many forms and ways. Also, charity is not only through assets or property, but charity can be in many forms. Money is not the only platform to perform charity. With that, everyone has chance to do charity in their own capacity. Sadaqah is not just restricted to any form of wealth, money, materials or good deeds. All good deeds done by Muslims for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit another being is considered as a sadaqah in Islam. It reminds me of a hadith narrated from Sa'in ibn Abi Burda. Ala kulli muslimin sadaqah. Faqalu ya nabiy Allah, faman lam yajid qala ya'mal biyadihi fayanfa' nafsahu wa yatasaddaq. Qalu fa in lam yajid qala yu'inu dhal hajatil malhuf. Qalu fa in lam yajid qala faly'mal bil ma'ruf wal yumsik 'anil sharr fa innaha lahu sadaqah. Which means Prophet, peace be upon him, once said, every Muslim has to give in sadaqah or charity. The people asked, O Allah's Messenger, peace be upon him, if someone has nothing to give, what will he do? He said, he should work with his hands and benefit himself and also give in charity from what he earns. The people further asked, if he cannot do even that, he replied, then he should help the needy who appeal for help. Then the people asked, if he cannot do that as well, he replied, then he should perform all that is good and keep away from all that is evil. And this, in return, will be regarded as a charitable deed. Sadaqah can be performed by any Muslim with the intention of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and doing good to his brother. To be eligible to give sadaqah, one need not be very wealthy, but rather have pure intentions. Making dua for the well-being of someone is also a form of sadaqah. Feeding the poor, to smile in the company of your brother, pouring water from your jug into the cup of your brother. These are all various examples of charity that can be easily attained or practiced in our daily life. Ramadan is also the month of opportunity to gain as much rewards as possible. Besides Zakat Fitrah, it is also encouraged for us to do charity in the month of Ramadan. It was narrated from Ubaidullah bin Abdullah bin Utbah that Abdullah bin Abbas used to say, "The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the most generous of people, and he was most generous in Ramadan when Jibril met him. Jibril used to meet him every night during the month of Ramadan and study Quran with him. And he said, when Jibril met him, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was more generous in doing good than the blowing wind." So, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, giving out sadaqah does not necessarily mean giving out monetary donations, but it can vary from anything. So here are a list of 5 charitable acts you can do this Ramadan, or we can practice together this Ramadan to enjoy the blessings of spreading goodness. Number 1, make dua. When you know of someone in hardship or see someone is suffering, the best gift you can give them is to make dua for them. This is the most powerful weapon we have as believers, especially in the month of Ramadan. The way in which your dua may aid someone is something outstanding. Number 2, taking care of children or the elderly. So at home during this circuit breaker period, we can take care of our children and our elderly parents if you are staying with them. If they are not staying with you, you can always call your parents to ask what would they like to eat for iftar, for example, and have someone deliver the food for them. This also counts as charity. Number 3, spread the word. In Ramadan, there are always charity projects and fundraising events that friends, families, and acquaintances are raising money for. While you may not be able to offer much financially yourself, you can help by spreading the word for the work others are doing. Use your phone, email, Facebook, and other methods of communication to promote and allow others to reap the benefits of donating. Number 4, give away items. Ramadan is a perfect time to declutter your bedroom and donate these items to a charity organization, or simply to give to those in your life who you know are struggling. We all accumulate many things we do not use anymore. By donating to charity, not only are you helping others, but you are also helping yourself, detaching from material possessions that you may be hoarding all this while. And lastly, smile. We often underestimate the power of a smile, as it is a form of communication that is universally accepted. Smile at those who you do not know, because we do not know the effect this smile can have on a person. Our act of kindness could be the one thing that lightens their heart and gives them joy. For example, during the month of Ramadan, when you want to break fast, you often order online. Then when the delivery guys come to your house, then you in return, you can just smile at them and they will feel happy, and that is also considered a charitable deed. So now, the reward of charity is so great and unimaginable. It is also mentioned in Surah Baqarah verse 261, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains about this. مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ حَبَّةٍ أَنْبَتَتْ سَبْعَ سَنَابِيلَ فِي كُلِّ سُنْبُلَةٍ مِئَةُ حَبَّةٍ وَاللَّهُ يُدَعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Which means, the example of those who spend their wealth in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like a seed of grain which grows 7 spikes. In each spike is 100 grains, and Allah multiplies His reward for whom He wills. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all-encompassing and knowing. So the verse here indicates that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grows the good deeds of its doers. He will increase according to the person's sincerity in his deeds, and He has full knowledge in whoever deserves it or does not deserve it. And lastly, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, before I conclude, a reminder to us all. Allah wants to see the quality, not the quantity of our charity. The quality here means our sincerity in performing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not for other worldly intentions. As we are all aware by now, actions are always judged by our intentions. Performing an act solely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the number one priority, and it should always include being sincere, being ikhlas in our actions. There are also various ways in attaining sincerity. Do righteous deeds. The more good deeds that we do, and hence we get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more sincere we will be. For example, since we are talking about wealth and acts of charity, what we donate to charity or sadaqah should always be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for the purpose in helping those in need. The amount of money does not matter if we have bad traits in our hearts or just solely to please our ego or to show off our wealth to others. So do remember, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, before we do any good deed or any deed at all, we should firstly seek knowledge, seek ilm. Our actions or deeds should be guided by knowledge so that we do them in accordance to the Sharia. Do not also give false impressions to others. Do not make others believe that an action we did was good when it was not initially. Al-Imam Ahmad once said, before you do anything, check your intention, check your niyyah. Ask yourself before performing an action, is it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or is it for gaining recognition, popularity or applause from others? Refrain yourself, ladies and gentlemen, from being boastful and arrogant in the eyes of people, but instead humble yourself in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and showcase good characteristics in front of people so that they can emulate what we do and incorporate it in their daily lives. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease our affairs in attaining His blessings based on our actions. Always remember, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, it is not about the number of deeds that we have done that matters, but the quality or the amount of sincerity that is present in our acts of worship or our general deeds. Those are the things that matters to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With that, I conclude this Road to Ramadan series. I sincerely hope that during these 4 weeks, you, the viewers, have learned something beneficial from this and try to practice and inculcate what I have shared during this year's Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of our deeds done during Ramadan later. I shall see each and every one of you soon, inshallah. Till next time, Ustaz Khidir here signing off. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullahal azim li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.